Hey babes. Morning. It's that kind of morning. Gotta whip your hair back and forth. Hey, I'm gonna be talking about jealousy today, guys. So heart it up. If you're all about whipping your hair up, you can't like not dance when this is on. Alright, so let me turn this down a little. Alright, guys. So, yes, we're going to talk about... Actually, let me turn that off altogether because I'm going to start dancing the whole thing. Morning! Hey! Hey, Tressa! So this morning I want to talk to you about jealousy, okay? And swipe to the left if you want to share this with your peeps because I'm going to share some good tips on what to do if you're having feelings of jealousy, okay? So heart it up if you've ever been jealous, because we all have those moments. And I'm actually going to share a story from my own experience feeling jealous of someone this week and what that actually meant. So this week I was on Facebook, as you do, and I noticed a lawyer that I have mentored in the past. She actually started her practice after me, and I was, you know, very helpful and supportive of her as she was starting. And so I saw that she had like this kick-ass amazing speaking gig this week, you know? And so I was like, wow, that is amazing. I'm so happy for her. And then I was like, actually, why not me? Why am I not doing that speaking gig? And I started to feel all jealous. And I was like, that is so whack, Rachel. What is up with that? Because I'm usually not the jealous type. Like, usually I'm walking through my life all day thinking, shit, my life is fucking awesome. You know, I'm pretty happy all day. So it was weird to me to suddenly have these like strong feelings of, that doesn't feel good. I'm pissed. You know, especially if someone I really like, you know, that is so shitty to feel jealous of someone who you love. And, you know, I'm always super supportive of other women entrepreneurs. And that's why I've trained and mentored so many lawyers and helped them create their own practices. So like, what is up with that? So, you know, I noticed that and it kind of put me in a funk a little bit for the day. Hey, from Kazakhstan. Thanks for joining. So I was like trying to explore what that is about. Like, what am I dealing with? And I realized what that really has to do with is like not this other person at all. You know, I love her. She's awesome. I've totally shared her stuff. Hey, stinky cakes. I was feeling really, you know, shitty about feeling jealous of her. And I realized really what that was about is my own bullshit, right? As it always is. It's always about our own bullshit. Hey, from Brazil. Thanks for joining. You know, so it was really about me not stepping out and doing the things that I should be doing, right? The things that I want to create. Because when I really thought about it, I was like, well, that speaking gig, if I think about it, what's going to happen? You know, if I did that speaking gig, then I'd get a whole bunch of a particular type of client who's going to be at that speaking gig, right? I don't even want those types of clients. That's not even the people that I work with. So why the hell am I jealous? You know, but I realized really what it was about. Thanks, Teresa. Yes, it is so true. I realized what it's really about is me not stepping out and doing the things that I know I need to be doing. Thanks for inviting followers, Stinky Cakes. Hey, Marie, thanks for joining. So I realized it's really about me not taking action on the stuff that I know I need to be doing. And why am I not doing that? Well, the typical culprit, which is fear, right? Fear stops all of us dead in our tracks because we're just scared all the time of putting ourselves out there, of, you know, showing who we truly are to like the world, you know, and failing. You know, we're scared to fail. And a lot of us too are scared of being successful as well. So anyway, that's what I realized. And so what I did, which, you know, some of the members of my team are on this scope, so they're going to be like, I'm going to fucking kill Rachel. But what I did was I made a commitment to do those things that I've been scared to do. All of them. And by committing, what I really mean is that I posted it on Facebook and announced it to like thousands of people. And by doing that, I know I'm going to have to follow through and do it, which is exactly why I did that. Yes. Tressa, Lauren, Gloria, are you hearing this? No one kill Rachel. Thank you, Natalia. So that's what I did. So I announced a retreat that I'm doing next spring, which I'm honestly still fucking scared to death. Once I wrote that post on Facebook, I was literally nauseous. I was so scared. Thanks, Teresa. I appreciate that. Lauren is saying, that's the attorney on my team. Thank you, Tressa. I love you back. So I announced that I'm going to do a retreat for service entrepreneurs who want to create their own info product, which is something I've been very successful at and something that I've really been wanting to do for people for a long time. Now I just made that commitment to do it. I committed to writing my book proposal, and now I'm working with someone who is keeping me accountable, David Moldauer. He's awesome if you want to write a book. So I'm working with him, and we started yesterday. And I'm launching my podcast all at the same time, just like putting it out there, getting it done, you know? So if you are scared of doing something, just tell us right now, like just write it right now. Just like be bold and just put it out there. David Moldauer is his name. You can find him at bookietect.com. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that. Bookietect. It's BOOKIETECT.com. That's where you can find David. He's awesome. And the podcast is going to be with Ariane Trelon, who's just an amazing, awesome person. Yes. Yes, Natalia. I've been there. Not scared. Just having trouble starting. Totally had that experience keeping momentum. Hey, Ebong, how are you?
Hey.
Ebong was actually the one who put me onto Periscope in the first place. We were both doing like an appearance on TheRoot.com's like television show together, and it was very lively. It's coming out in November, so I'll tell you guys when that happens. But anyway, yeah, so if you have something that you know you need to be doing, that's probably where your feelings of jealousy are coming from. That's what it means. It means there's something you know you need to be doing that you're not doing. Yes, yes, good, Teresa, I love it. Tell on yourself. It's good to do, okay? So if you are having those feelings of jealousy and the green-eyed monster just comes and attacks you suddenly when you're on Facebook looking at someone else's life and it just looks so awesome and you're like, why is my life not that awesome? It's because of something that you are not doing. And you know what that is. You don't need to hire a coach or like any special professional to tell you what it is. You know, okay? So just look inside. You are reminding me of Dynamite Boom in the face. Thanks, Murray. That's the first I've heard that. But yes, you know, so if you're feeling those feelings of jealousy, you know that that means that there's something that you are not taking action on. So just put it out there, announce it on Facebook, tell people on Twitter, tell your friends, just write it in, you know, your newsletter, like just do what you have to do to get it out there so that you have to commit. Because once you put it out there to the world, you can't not follow through, right? So you have to do what you got to do and make it happen. Okay. So if you're feeling jealous, that's what it's about, peeps. And the only way to correct it is just to take that action. And I have to say, like, I did that yesterday and I woke up today just feeling so hype, right? That's why I was like whipping my hair when we started, because I'm just feeling like so alive and full of energy because I'm taking action. Am I any less scared? No, I am not. Thank you so much, Grizel. Grizel does all of the amazing makeup that's in all of the pictures that you see of me online. So my Periscope profile picture, that was Grizel's magic that made that happen. This is just regular face. yes, take imperfect action. Yes, Teresa, I totally agree. yes, I totally agree. Just do whatever you have to do to just make something happen, you know, and just take that first step, announce it, just fucking put it out there. Because if you do that, you're not going to backtrack. You've made that commitment to yourself and you're going to take action. And you'll notice next time you see one of your girls or a friend of yours doing really, really well, you're going to be like, you know what? I'm happy for you. I'm not jealous at all. Actually, I'm thrilled for you. I'm going to send you a little note to tell you how happy I am for you. That's how you're going to feel. You're not going to feel jealous. Okay. All right. Thanks so much for joining me, guys. Bye-bye. Have a great day.